But I'm all about the peace until your sucker hit a make. Oh man, eat man, your performance kinda shaky. I'm prepared for the fame, I like that crap, sound really like me. But I'd be lying if I said I didn't cry at least once a week. Cause I'm so blessed with no stress, all the weight taking off of me. Head in the clouds and I smile like no grandma watching me. My dream came true, I'm loving all these cameras in my face. I never knew that I would get the love from my state. Stay with the blue, always keep the money coming in. Ain't nothing new, writing it till I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's for clout and hitters, man. You can never be a such you carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up, trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm placing.
Considered a wonderful fall afternoon for football here in Tampa at Raymond James Stadium. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. Fake here on first down, rolling to his left.
They're going for Howard, but the pass intercepted.
Picked off at the 38, and he's able to get it back to right around the 27. Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
They try and run on first down, but to no avail. Tackle for a 2-yard loss in the backfield.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
On play action, Prescott. They'll roll him out right. He finds his man complete. That's Webster. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Now Prescott. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. After getting that turnover on the first drive of the game, you'd hate to just stall out the momentum, go three and out. They're able to avoid that there.
And we talk about complimentary football all the time, but I think it's a little bit deeper than that. Defense went out, forced a turnover, gave the ball to the offense. It's now the offense's responsibility to pay that off for them, to show respect to them. Hey, you guys got the turnover. We appreciate it. They want to continue their drive.
And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Here's Prescott. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds.
And that's a nice job of working his way open down in the red zone. Looked that one in and then made a beeline for the pylon. He didn't quite get there, and you want to give him a little extra for the effort, but instead he sets his guys up in excellent shape with a first and goal.
First and goal, a chance to convert that early turnover into points. Henry is in. Touchdown, Dallas. Just power football there. Down near the goal line. Give it to him. He's able to push his way across.
Yeah, they went heavy there. Sometimes you have those big offensive linemen come and have to report like they're eligible. But all they're doing is getting a good stance, blocking, and getting their runner across the goal line.
Extra point right down the middle, and that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
Yeah, a little bit of humor. Got to laugh that one off, and not the ha-ha, that was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Jones with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game. So there, Charles, I mean, a situation where it didn't matter how far he had to run, he was not going to be denied, and he winds up taking this all the way to the end zone. The point after is good. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Well, that is a running back who was not about to go down easily. He fought his way through the contact until the seas opened up for him.
And with a guy his size, you have to know defensively that arm tackles aren't going to fly with him. You have to be able to wrap up, or else he can just brush tacklers aside like they're not even there.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 44 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times. Last week, of course, the great performance, over 200 yards. He still wants to be fed.
And they should. That's exactly what you should do. I have not yet met a running back that's run for over 200 yards that says the very next week, hey, let's back things
yeah,
off.
Yeah, I don't need it as much.
No, they want it more and more. They're going to be ready to go because they think that's going to happen naturally now.
Here's a quick throw by Dak, complete out wide. A gain of six there on first. If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes it's just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
Now it's a bootleg with Prescott. He's got his man on the crossing route. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 13-yard line.
And partner, they're locked in man coverage out left and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. And he's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field. And that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Running left, Henry. This carry, despite the extra effort, will be stopped short of the 10. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Only able to gain a couple there. And they're going to have a third down.
Brandon, you know this is going to be discussed because this is the fear of all the backs when they run this type of a route. They've got to find the football, and sometimes they don't see the defender. And in this case, he took a pretty good shot for his efforts, but give him credit, able to hold on to the football.
Third down, it's Prescott. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Consecutive gains of 1, 2, and now 3 yards. Brings up fourth down.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game. But it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go up and make the tackle right away.
And forthcoming, a field goal try for the Cowboys. From the right hash, and this one just a chipping. And his kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made him kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
But hopefully there's some determination that sets in because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Here's a give to Jones running left. He finds some open field here. And finally, he is out of bounds, but not before taking it down near the 15. A big run there by Jones. Yardage-wise, he's in the top handful of backs in the league so far this season. A great run there.
He's going to love that standing when it comes to contract time. But even more so, his team loves it because he gives them an identity and sets a tone.
10-7 our score after one right here on EA Sports. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. And his throw here is incomplete.
Speed is the name of the game when it comes to RPOs, and sometimes you can be a little too quick, thus inaccurate, incomplete.
Second and 10. A give to Jones. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10.
That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
Yeah, the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back. Looking to throw. Nash. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
And now the Tampa Bay field goal unit comes out here. And his kick is indeed good. And that will knot us up at 10. Maybe a little fortunate there. That was leaking a little, maybe leaking a lot, but he got it.
Yeah, he actually was able to make it work. How about the body language, though, right? As he watched that ball leak to the right, trying to bring it back in. And had just enough to get it done.
The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material.
Here's a second and two now from the 33. Off the play fake, Prescott. He'll buy some time right. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Prescott on third and two. Swinging this out for Pollard. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Carry for Henry. Oh, fighting off the defender.
And this is going to be a Cowboys first down as the tackle made it about the 43-yard line.
And we were down on the field watching Henry warm up before the game. He's a big man. No wonder he breaks those tackles.
And you remember what I told you when we were watching? It's not all pads. Yeah. I mean, you get him out of pads and just see him in a regular suit or an outfit. He is a huge human being and a lot faster than what people know. When he gets rolling, he's a lot to bring down.
Play fake. Here's Prescott. He finds his man complete. That's Webster. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage.
Now they'll employ the jumbo set now on second and one.
Now a handoff to Henry. Fighting his way through contact. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one.
89 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. And they've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass.
Trying to punch it in with Henry. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Derrick Henry with his 14th touchdown of the year, second of the game. And the Cowboys have broken the tie. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes it a 17-10 score. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They find themselves down 17-10 as they come up on a first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Nash, he finds his tight end Howard. That's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Well, you know, this club, there were some reports earlier in the week, and most have heard this by now, is so-called unnamed sources that were saying all is not rosy in that locker room. There's whispers that one or two guys, CD, have kind of had enough of how things are going and have been going. How would you handle that as a coach?
Well, you and I both know all the coaches that we've dealt with and come in contact with. They'd love to get their hands on those unnamed sources, wouldn't they? But they know that that's not possible. So I think they've got to go in there and make sure that this isn't a distraction. They also know that once the grumbling starts, it becomes a slippery slope and it's hard to stop the fall. But I think you need to sit some guys down and say, hey, look, we're still hoping to be a playoff team this year. We need you guys to be...
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
The good news, they kept the ball. Bad news, it's third and long. Back to throw. Nash. This one complete to Scott Miller. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. It'll be a pickup of 14, but they're still a little bit short as it brings up fourth. Here comes the Buccaneers punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. 7 yards on the return after a punt of 39. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? Two touchdowns on a field goal in their first three possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Meanwhile, Dak's throw taken in by Diggs. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. He's been the forgotten man in this first half. Not a guy you want to forget. Not only his first catch, first time they've targeted him.
That doesn't make any sense, does it?
Not
because those are the types of plays that he provides. When he does come alive, when they do look his way, not only is it a big catch, it's a first down.
Prescott on first down. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
Well, so far, little to no resistance by the defense on this drive alone. Three passes, three completions, three first downs. They're taking it to them, and it's paying off.
And again, it's Prescott. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Cooper. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 7 yards to pick up there.
A 7-yard pickup brings up second and three.
Throwing again on second down. Prescott throwing the out route incomplete. It's Lamb. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. Well, they brought the pressure, and that meant man coverage behind him, so he's still able to complete the pass.
Even as he took the hit. And that's what you have to do, because I was just talking with a coach the other day, and he said, look, it's not always going to be pretty back there. You're going to have to give me completions, even when you're taking some hits. Sometimes you have to be your own blitz control, for lack of a better term. Got to make completions, step up and make those throws, and he did that.
Prescott yet again. Touchdown, Cowboys! A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further.
And that's certainly an important score right there, because they gave themselves a two-score cushion heading towards halftime. Now you got to force the other team out of their comfort zone, and it changes the way you approach the second half as well. How you want to do things on offense, and your defense feels much better too, having that lead.
Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead now up to 14. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession as they take over with exactly 1 minute to go. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Off the play fake. Nash steps away. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 30-second mark of this first half. Down. Nash flushed out right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. Thrown across his body and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 12. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand and they'll take that.
Good starting position for the Cowboys here as they come up first and 10 at their own 44. Play action now, Prescott. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Joe Tryon able to get in there and run him down for what's going to be a loss of 15 yards all told. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. Final play of the half, Prescott. Going for the deep ball. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off near the 32, and he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Cowboys out on top. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Final preparations being made for the second half, both in terms of game plan and also hydration, because humidity is really going to catch up to these guys, no doubt. And for the call of the second half, we go back to Brandon Godd.
Yeah, Coach. Hey, that goes for the announcers, too. No AC in this booth, so we've got a mash unit of empty water bottles up here as well. The question to be asked, where does this game go from here as we are back at it now on EA Sports? And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in the second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coach is up in the...
There he goes, left side. Past the 20.
What's up?
Touchdown, Cowboys.
Boy, CeeDee Lamb so prolific at Oklahoma, catching passes like this from Kyler Murray, and he's doing it at the NFL level too.
And plenty to praise on the play, but this is also a bit of a breakdown defensively because you've got to be right on him when he makes the catch. Otherwise, he has the ability to really make you pay, and he does right there, picking up excellent real estate after the catch.
Extra point right down the middle, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And their halftime hole now even deeper, and they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger, but no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Off play action. Nash sliding out of the pocket. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Looking to throw. Nash. It's Miller, complete. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A big connection on that one. 33 yards.
Well, dialing up that play call certainly meant that he grabbed a little extra shot of courage on that one because normally on third and short, you're just trying to move the sticks, get the ball just past that line of scrimmage. Instead, they take the big shot downfield, and it pays off.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10, just outside the 30. On first down, it's Jones. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. That really sets him back. A loss of 6. Tough spot looking at second and 16 here after the big loss. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked off by Kelvin Joseph. And the Cowboys force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 27. He'll start with a give to Henry. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32.
96 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Well, I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
Second down, they go again with Henry.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
A solid run by Derrick Henry, and here's another first and 10.
Check, check, check.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory.
Joe Tryon there to make the tackle.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Running left, it's Henry. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
It's been a remarkable day at the office for him running the football. Those yards just continue to pile well past 100.
And how about more than double-digit carries in the second half alone? That's what you want as a runner, because you've got to prove to your offensive line that you're going to be as tough as they are. They don't rotate in and out on every play. Running backs often do, so those who can stay out there with their offensive linemen, those are the guys they really value.
They'll try to throw now. Prescott out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Takes this to the 32, maybe the 31, and then the defense rallying quickly after that broken tackle.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup if someone's trying to cover them. But they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
On second down, here's Henry. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. Four-yard pickup leaves him with third and one.
They're a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. Again, it's Henry. Muscles him off. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Henry will get it. He's been busy today. And he's going to have just a couple here with a marker on the field as well. That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
Prescott off play action. And he's got his man in stride, complete. They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds, because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you?
Looking to throw again on second down. Prescott throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Something we haven't really seen much of from him, an incomplete pass.
Yeah, last week he finished at 70%. This week he's up over 80%. I don't know how you slow him down. Pass rush is usually the best way because a quarterback on his back usually can't complete a pass.
This will be play number 9 of the drive here as they need 4 yards on third down. Here's Prescott. Over the middle, Amari Cooper, it's complete.
Yeah, the Cowboys are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
A lot of deflated looks on that defense. It seems like they just cannot find a way to get a key stop on third down. Here's another conversion, and now this offense, they're in a position to go up even further as they've got it first and goal.
They'll try and run for it with Henry, and he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Second and goal from the 1. It's a keeper with Prescott. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down. Here's Henry. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Derrick Henry. Excellent work there to get in on the touchdown run. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. Now the extra point try forthcoming. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And 3 interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number 4's kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw 4.
No, what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown 3, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second and 6, just inside the 30. Again, it's Jones. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
The Bucs on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Back to throw. Nash. Got a man complete to Miller. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
They go play action here on first down, eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now before this 2nd down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter.
Here's second and 10.
Throwing again, Nash. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. He's picked off near his own 48. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown.
Defensively, they've had their way in this one. That pick six makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? He said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. I might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. They'll go again to Jones. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
Looking to throw, Nash. And now look at this, big gain, but a fumble.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Flush to his right. Now he's going to throw it back deep over the middle. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. A big play that time through the air. 37 yards.
At this stage, there's nothing left to do but to keep firing. And if you're a play caller, you may go off your sheet and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked. Switch! Switch!
They'll run on first down. Jones, he'll get forward for 3 down to the 16-yard line.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run in the pass, but in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU, most valuable unit, but you're right, it might go to them in this game.
I like that, MVU. Well done.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8.
Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
The Bucs on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Off the play fake. Nash under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Micah Parsons in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to 4th down.
Come on.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Bucs try it on fourth down, but come up empty. And the Cowboys' defense is going to get them the football back. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example, and now, obviously, they're in a great spot here.
Yeah, if you're over on the bench right now, you're shaking hands with your teammate, you're hugging him.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 40, and he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Now they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over.
On first down. It's Jones, and he's got room, and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
158 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long.
And this will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning. Off play action. Nash on the move to his left. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. Just like that. 14th. Here comes the blitz as they look to throw. Here's Johnson with a reception. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
They'll try and sneak it here. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late. But he does get in for six.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. And they wasted no time right down near the goal line, and they just sneak it in.
Just do what you need to do. Big guys going up front. Have the field general, the leader, just fall in behind him.
The extra point up and good. And that'll cut the lead down a bit to 28. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And it's looking all the more likely that a fifth straight win is going to be in the cards. They'll try to run some time here with a first and 10.
Wrap up.
Still moving. And some room to work. Derrick Henry. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, business as usual for them. Well on their way to another victory. Riding a serious wave of momentum from what we've seen. And so far, they haven't met their match. So if you're going to play this team in the future, your mission is clear. You better be ready to play and match their firepower.
Point after, right down the middle. And that will extend this big lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Offense set to begin their next possession. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory. But he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown. But they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use, than that. Man, one play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play, big time result.
And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt a return. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And this one has gone pretty well to form. They've come in, had little problem thus far, and now they'll try to polish things off in the fourth. Henry on first down, not finding much running room as he pushes forward for a yard or two at most.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Henry again on second down. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Dallas, their strong September has carried over to October as they move to 5-0. And they'll have another road date next week with the Carolina Panthers. Meanwhile, for Tampa Bay, they'll fall to 1-4 with a loss. And they will try to get back in the swing of things next week on the road.
Salute when you see me. That jealousy is an ocean, and you either float or you sink. Moment of truth, credit check. You not a pool. BB King, I'm in love with the blues. Don't start me up, I got finishing moves. Look. Salute when you see me. Slid through all the commotion, it's breaking news, they got an ad on TV. Popping out all of my politics, and probably in a section where you not permitted. My honey's matching my Dodger fitted, playing all gold, ain't no stopping in it. Look, salute when you see me. I bought her a CC, and that was her purse. Disgusting what do for a purse, disgusting what do for the clout. I'm one of the realest could vouch. They thought I was done, but all that doubt, you gotta pay money, next around. Salute when you see me. Put in the car to the my runner gets you speedy. Still thugging like the days when they weren't here in my CD. Made it out of the trenches. Just salute when you see me. Yeah, salute when you see me. I'm getting greedy. I blow the whole budget on me. That's on me. I'm conceited. Treaty. Nah, that ain't how we treat it. This right here sound like a three-peat. I put the dip in it, sound like a three-peat. I'm like, oh, fuck you too needy. Me and HB going Juvie and BG. They gotta put my face on the box of Wheaties. I'm praying for whoever think they competed. Salute when you see me. That's all he ever, so that's how you greet me. I'm going TM-101, Jeezy, and plus they got D2 on repeat. I'm with the love of my life for like 3 weeks, cause that's all I needed. She wanna go on a trip or retreat, but I'm sorry, I never retreated. I set the bar so high that you might as well leave it. I'm going undefeated, I've broken the system. Had to breach it, that's mission impossible, mission completed. Salute when you see me, oh yeah. I got the heart of a god and a genie. I want you to love me, I want you to need me. When I this face is defeated. I gotta get back to the hood, I remember when I was the needy. Clean me up, squeaky. She fell in love, deeply. They like what I say, they repeat me. Look, all this money I be spending on BBs. That's why you gotta salute when you see me.
And they hate that. I ain't even hungry, but I ate.